Hey everyone, Tinkenstein here. Are you thinking about downloading War Thunder? If so, this is the video for you. I'll go over some of the most important things that you need to know before you decide to download War Thunder, or on the other hand, decide not to download it. This video is a part of a series of three videos going over War Thunder intended for beginners, as I also have a video for those who have already downloaded the game and are brand new to it who have never played a match, and another video for those who are still relatively new but have played a few matches. I have both of these videos linked below, as well as my full War Thunder Explained playlist of over 35 videos that I've made that go over almost every facet of War Thunder that you need to know in detail. That said, enough with this intro. Let's get into the video. So, that all being said, for number one, War Thunder is a free-to-play game that has arguably pay-to-win elements to it. The list is highly debatable, and for that fact that it is arguable alone, I would not consider War Thunder to be pay-to-win. I've actually created a video about this exact topic that I've linked below. It is largely pay-to-progress, however, as once you've earned your first 15 to 20 vehicles for any nation in a given tech tree, be it air, ground, or even fewer if it's naval, you might start experiencing difficulty earning more vehicles without buying premium time or premium vehicles to speed up progression and give you more in-game currency per match. Do not let this be an obstacle, however, as the lower tiers are oftentimes some of the most played and some of the most fast-paced matches in-game. They're also some of the most fun as well. For number two, War Thunder is fairly realistic in that it uses real vehicles, such as the Tiger II tank or P-51 Mustang, and even planes like the MiG-21 and ships like the Prinz Eugen. Each in-game vehicle is modeled after a real-world vehicle, and all have their stats, armor, and weaponry all based on blueprints and other reliable sources. These are not fictitious vehicles like what other games of this genre might contain. To this point, there are over 1,700 vehicles currently in-game, spread across air, ground, and naval, and currently, as of the recording of this video, 9 different nations that you can play. These nations are the US, Germany, Russia, Great Britain, Japan, China, Italy, France, and Sweden, with possibly more countries and vehicles being currently added every few months. These run the gamut from pre-World War II vehicles through the modern day, with everyone being able to play all sorts of vehicles intended for all different types of roles, such as bombers, attackers, and fighters for air, and light, medium, and heavy tanks for ground forces, to name just a few. And in addition to this, if you look at the nations, you can see exactly how many vehicles they all have, and there are tons of vehicles, especially for the USA, Germany, and the USSR, but also for Great Britain, Japan, and also to a point China. Italy, France, and Sweden are currently being worked on, but they still have tons of vehicles as well. If you want a more complete picture of what are in each of these tech trees, I would suggest going to the War Thunder Wiki and then looking exactly what you might be able to find. You can find each of these tech trees duplicated online, again, in the War Thunder Wiki. As you can see here, you have the Army, helicopters, aviation, blue water fleet, which is destroyers and up, and also coastal fleet, which tends to be anything smaller than destroyers. Which leads me to point number three. There's a playstyle and a game mode for everyone. You could, for example, prefer strictly simulator flying with pre-World War II biplanes. If this is the case, War Thunder has that game mode for you. You could like flying tons of fast, deadly, cannon-laden World War II German fighters with somewhat lax, though still good physics. If this is so, you can play Air Arcade once you reach that part of the German air tech tree. Do you like the idea of storming through the desert in a fully modern main battle tank? War Thunder has that as well. To this point, War Thunder has enough vehicles and game modes for everyone. Though this game is a bit more serious than World of Tanks, for example, as even the most relaxed game mode in War Thunder, which is Arcade Mode, is still substantially more realistic than World of Tanks. I feel that it is easier to get into, and if you're a fan of history like myself, you can play how you want with the vehicles that you've only read about in books or seen on TV. For me personally, War Thunder is a historical paradise, as I can fly I can ride around the mouse. I can, for example, fly around in the HO229, which is a dream plane for me, the ME262, there's numerous variants of that, and hopefully in the future, the ME262HG1 as well. There's tons of everything for everyone here. You can go crazy. For number four, this game benefits those who play it for more than just a few days. Aside from being able to progress farther in various tech trees, playing for longer will allow you to get better and thus will allow you to be more likely to have fun. You may have it where one day you've been playing for months, where something just clicks for you in game, and you go from being mediocre to above average. There are so many facets to this game that even besides learning each individual vehicle and each vehicle variant's strengths and weaknesses that you can learn, that playing for a week or two will hardly allow you to scratch the surface of this game. I've been playing War Thunder for nearly 7 years, or actually over 7 years, and I'm still learning something new about this game, whether it's how to better play a vehicle or something having to do with gameplay mechanics, nearly every single day. Be open to learning and you'll eventually be among the best. Additionally, as sad as it may be for new players, top tier players do come down to play with beginners every now and again. So don't just get discouraged if you do poorly in your first few matches. There is a learning curve, but once you learn the basics, you'll do well. And for number 5, there is a vibrant and active community full of people that share an interest in War Thunder, of which many of these people are very helpful if you reach out to them, be they YouTubers or random people in a social media group or forum. If you have questions, ask them and they will likely be answered, albeit with possibly a few troll responses. Additionally, this is a fairly active game with a relatively consistent player base and player count, though it has increased a bit starting in 2020. Additionally, the developer, Gaijin, releases major patches every few months containing new vehicles for you to earn. Between those major releases, they have plenty of patches that modify gameplay to try to keep it balanced. Whether this actually works or not is up for you to decide once you decide to download and play this game. And finally, as a side note, but something that is still very important to know before you download War Thunder, if I did not make it clear before, there are numerous different game types including air, ground, and naval battles, and they're all integrated into War Thunder, so you don't have to download numerous different games to play each. You simply click right up here, and you're ready to switch which type of match or vehicle that you'd like to play. So you can switch from all of these different game types, and down here you can switch your vehicles and nations. Also, airplanes are integrated into both ground and naval battles, so if you're playing in a ship or in a tank, you also have the ability to spawn into the match with one of your planes. In addition to this, there are three different types of game modes / realism types, which are arcade mode, realistic, and simulator. These combine with the vehicle type so you can do things like play arcade air, or simulator ground, or realistic naval. As stated before, these options give you tons of different ways to play, as they each change gameplay dramatically, but not so much where it feels like a totally different game. But, that all said, thank you all so much for watching this video. Please, if you're intending to play War Thunder and would like regular content, again, for War Thunder, consider subscribing to my channel and hitting that notification bell. Also, if you enjoyed my video, consider subscribing as well. Either way, thanks again, everyone, and I'll see you all on the other side. Take care, everyone.